Play some of the music from our new CD while we're just mingling. So, thanks a lot.
Maybe once you can try the equipment, please feel free.
Thanks.
Is it comparable?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, absolutely.
Yeah. You're pleased with what you recorded there?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, what we've recorded is we hit a golden patch on the recording as well. Somehow we got this thing going between the two of us, you know, the two very different sorts of instruments.
Well, yeah, I know.
Analog versus digital.
This was making me laugh, Jordan, because I'd never imagined.
Oh, yeah, and I love you using Nintendo DS.
Yeah, it's fantastic. No, it was great. It was really great.
Thank you.
What were you doing with the handheld? Was that the...
Well, I was using an iPod Touch and a Nintendo DS.
Really?
Yeah.
Cool.
And the iPod, of course, has a lot of different apps. What I was using for the Nintendo DS was an app from Japan called Electroplankton. It's kind of a... toy, but it has lots of different sounds that you can manipulate in it. And you get all these little plankton-type characters they're supposed to be. And this one, for instance, sounds like a piano, but I was getting a lot of drone sounds out of just like these spinning plate ones. You spin them. It's not turned on now, but when you spin them, you get this long droning sound. And then there's also a built-in recorder in here. This guy, so you speak into the microphone, and I was just going, you know, dunch, dunch, dunch. And then there's all kind of each one of these around here make a different sound, reverse, lower, reverse and lower, and so I was playing with those, so it was kind of making that kind of real glitchy rhythm sound. Sometimes I do it with my voice, and depending on what Trevor is playing, I'll record straight up his amp, and then manipulate that sound. That comes out pretty interesting too. Electroplankton.
So conventionally you would write a piece of music and write sheet music. How would you make a representation of the
There's no sheet music, it's all notes.
You want to put us up there? That'd be great. I'm glad it sounded good. This is the first time we ever played this piece in public, Sky Snails Part 2, but I think we're starting to hit a little bit of a purple patch with it. This is the whole next album, recorded already. So it sounded just like the recording. That was nice for us, because our first album is really hard to sound like I've been in this business for years, the first album. This one is really hard to reproduce live. We tried it a few times, but this one, we actually nailed how to do it.
We were going to play tonight.
Though the synths are always playing up, so this synth is unstable, this mini mode, unfortunately. And so occasionally, it's unusual because it's something about the drift of it, but it works with the actual. We did it in the studio, and every time it did something it wasn't supposed to do, we used that, and it's like it was part of the creativity. And this one is amazed it stood up okay.
Yeah.
this is built in 1973.
Well, it's amazing. Right. Visually, it's just gorgeous. So I came back to take pictures.